I hope my screen is visible.
Yes, I can see your screen and I can hear you very well. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. So, good evening to all participants of the Third International Conference on Industry 4.0 and Smart Manufacturing ISM 2021. I am Dr. Praveen Tambe and I am working as a faculty in Operations Management and Decision Sciences in Indian Institute of Management, Tiruchirappalli, India. This presentation is about the paper on selective maintenance optimization of a multi-component system based on the simulated annealing algorithm. The basic purpose of this paper or the basic focus of this paper is on the maintenance decision. So as we know that maintenance, it involves combination of activities by which an equipment or a system is kept or restored to a state it will can perform its deregulation function. But conventionally, if we look at the maintenance, the conventional thinking of maintenance is to fix the things when they break down. But when the things break down or when the system goes in a breakdown state, that means maintenance has also failed. So the maintenance job is always to maintain so that it should never break, or it should provide at least some reliability in terms of the operations. In today's competitive world, where there exists a lot of competition, there is an increase in the number and the variety of the physical assets which are used, maybe in manufacturing or maybe in the production or the other kind of things. In fact, the complexity of the equipment has increased a lot, and nowadays new maintenance techniques are coming up. And also the views of the organizations are changing in terms of the maintenance decision. And nowadays maintenance is mostly looked at as an asset performance. And there is an also growing awareness on the maintenance in terms of whenever any equipment failure occurs, to what extent it affects the safety, to what extent it affects the environment. And nowadays, people look for the maintenance also from a sustainable point of view. There is also a growing awareness about the maintenance in terms of its connection between the different shop floor functions, maybe a production, maybe an inventory function, or maybe a production quality. For example, if you look at the maintenance and the production function, so if there are breakdowns during the operational periods, definitely it will affect the production, it will affect the production schedule, it will affect the inventory levels as well. Similarly, if any component of the machine, it has some connection with the product quality being manufactured on the machine, if it has some effect on the typical product quality characteristics of the product, so in that case the maintenance will also affect the product quality. So from this point of view, looking at the interconnection between the maintenance related with the production, maybe related with the product quality, there is also a growing awareness about the maintenance function from the point of view of production, from the point of view of inventory management, from the point of view of product quality also. And therefore, it creates a lot of pressure on the maintenance manager to achieve the high plant availability and also to curtail the maintenance cost, because nowadays, since there exists a lot of competition and the products, they are very price sensitive. So from that point of view, it creates a lot of pressure on maintenance management to look for the maintenance. Now in this paper, the focus is on the selective maintenance. That means the maintenance strategy that we have considered is a selective maintenance. So selective maintenance is basically a maintenance policy which is applicable to the equipments which are available during the break periods. So it involves identifying the subset of the maintenance activities. So for equipments like the military equipments which are available during a break period, that is a mission break, or it may be a production equipment on which the maintenance can be carried out mostly during the plant maintenance. So these plant maintenance, it serves a kind of a break period. And during these break periods, the time that is available for maintenance or the resources that are available for maintenance are not sufficient. so that the maintenance manager has to be selective in terms of selecting those components which can achieve a requirement in terms of the reliability or maybe in terms of the requirement of the availability. So in that way, this selective maintenance is the process of identifying the subset of the maintenance activity which can be completed within the available maintenance time or which can be completed within the available resources, so that the requirement of maybe the availability for a production equipment or maybe for some critical equipment, it may be in terms of the reliability achievement that can be fulfilled until the next mission and to fulfill that mission requirement. So as mentioned, so selective maintenance, it will involve the process of identifying the subset of the maintenance activities. So for a manufacturing equipment, the maintenance actions, it can be either the components can be repaired or the components can be replaced. So the old components will be replaced with a new component, or it can be a do nothing state because all the system components cannot be given the maintenance in terms of the repair or replacement. So definitely for a few component, it will be a do nothing or the skip maintenance at the current point of the maintenance opportunity. But of course, the decision on do nothing for a component is based on the available time, the available resources, and of course the mission requirement in terms of the availability requirement for the manufacturing equipment. So as a part of the model development, the model will include the three cost heads, that is the total cost of the replacement cost. So for those components which are replaced, the cost of replacement will be considered. Similarly, for those components which are repaired, the cost of repair will be considered. And even though the repair and replacement have been done for the component, and since there are few components for which do nothing action has been performed, so definitely there will be few failure event during the operational period of the equipment. So we need to also account for what can be the expected cost of the failure in the next mission interval. So this is a kind of a problem scenario that we have considered for the model development. So we have a current maintenance opportunity at which the maintenance manager has to take the maintenance decision based on the system availability requirement. And of course, there will be a last maintenance instance based on which the service age of the components will exist at the current maintenance opportunity. So the maintenance manager has to consider these service age of the component, and based on that service age, what maintenance actions that can be taken based on the requirement of the availability maybe in the next mission period, so that the maintenance can be completed within the time available. So let's say for example, the manufacturing equipment is available, let's say for 8 hours or two shifts, maybe 16 hours or maybe even a complete day. So whatever components are existing in the system, based on the service age, the maintenance manager has to come up with a decision that which component needs to be repaired, which component needs to be replaced, or for which component the maintenance will be skipped so that it can be considered at the next maintenance opportunity. And of course, the availability requirement will be considered in terms of the next mission requirement, that may be the next expected planned maintenance opportunity in this case. So these are some of the notations that will be utilized in the model development. So as mentioned, the cost of the maintenance will include the total cost of the replacement. So this first equation, it shows the cost of maintenance in terms of the component, which includes the downtime cost, then the cost of the labor, the cost of the component, that means the replacement cost of the component, and of course if the component is prematurely replaced, in that case the cost of loss of residual life is also needs to be considered. So the total cost of replacement will include for all those components which are replaced during the maintenance opportunity. The total cost of repair will include the downtime cost, then the cost of the labor, and cost of any spare or any consumable that will be used for that particular component. So for those components which are being given a repair action, the total cost of repair will include the sum of all those components which are repaired during the maintenance opportunity. And of course, as I already mentioned, that there will also, we need also need to account for the cost of failure, because there will be few components for which the maintenance will be skipped. So depending on the service age, there will be some chances of component failure during the next mission requirement or during the next operational period of that particular machine. So we need to account for the cost of failure as well. So this cost of failure will be based on whether the component is a repairable component or a non-repairable component, and of course what kind of maintenance action that needs to be given if the failure event occur for that particular component. So the total maintenance cost will be then include the repair cost, replacement cost and the failure cost. And for the optimization purpose, the optimization model is, the problem is formulated as minimizing the total maintenance decision cost and subject to the constraints on the availability, because for a maintenance manager, the availability requirement will be a very important factor as far as the next mission or the next operation period of the machine is concerned. So that availability based on the maintenance decision, it should be greater than or equal to the target availability requirement based on the shop floor conditions. And the second constraint that we have considered here is that the time to complete the maintenance actions for the components, whether it's a repair or replace, it should be completed within the available time for which the machine is available for maintenance. So that should be less than or equal to the available time. For optimization purpose, we have used a simulated annealing algorithm. So this shows the pseudo code for the simulated annealing algorithm that we have used. So the simulated annealing algorithm will involve an iterative approach, and over the iterations of this algorithm, the algorithm will generate the new maintenance decision satisfying the constraint, and the algorithm, when it will reach the stopping condition, it will result in a near optimal solution for the problem. Okay, so for modeling purpose, as we mentioned, that there will be three maintenance actions for the component. Either it can be repaired, it can be replaced, or the maintenance will be skipped for a given component. So for maintenance decision, for the modeling purpose in the simulated annealing, we have considered a string of three numbers, that is 1, 2 and 3, to designate the actions for the component. For example, 1 denotes the repair action, 2 denotes the replacement, and 3 denotes the no action, that is do nothing. So for a multi-component system, let's say which involves let's say n components, the maintenance decision will be in terms of a string of these numbers like 1, 2 or 3. This is the flowchart of the implementation of the simulated annealing algorithm for the optimization purpose. So the algorithm will start with selecting the parameters of the SA algorithm, that means the cooling schedule parameters. And during its operation of the algorithm, the algorithm will generate a maintenance decision for the component. And for a generated maintenance decision, we need to calculate the time that is required and the expected availability that will result from the maintenance decision to check the constraint. And in case the constraints are satisfied, it will go to the next stage. That means we need to calculate the expected cost of the maintenance decision, because the objective function or the fitness function, we can say, for the algorithm that we have considered is the total cost of the maintenance decision. So like this, over the iterations of the simulated annealing algorithm, new maintenance decisions will be generated in the neighborhood of the current maintenance decision, which will satisfy the constraints, and this algorithm will iterate towards optimizing the maintenance decision till the stopping condition is reached. And once we have reached to the stopping condition, the generated or the optimized maintenance decision will be the final optimal decision, or we can say the near optimal decision for the implementation purpose. For demonstration, we have considered, let's say, an n component system in which we have considered 15 components for a given system, and we have considered the data related to the wavelet shape parameter, then the scale parameter, that is the characteristic life of the component. Then of course we need the time data, that is the mean repair time, mean replacement time, and of course the cost data may be related with the cost of the component, cost of the failure cost or the sub-component cost, depending on whether the component is a repairable component or the non-repairable component. The operational parameters for the maintenance decision for demonstration we have considered as the availability requirement, let's say 92% maybe in the next operating interval, and the next operating interval for the machine is considered to be 1000 hours. So based on, and of course these are the user inputs, so based on the user input and the requirement by the maintenance manager, the algorithm will come up with the maintenance decision based on these operational requirement. The parameters which are selected for implementing the simulated handling algorithm, these are initial temperature of 20 lakhs, then temperature reduction factor of 0.95. So the temperature will be reduced with a factor of 0.95, and at each temperature level, the maintenance decision will be searched in terms of the 10 numbers. So that indicate the loop factor for the simulated handling algorithm. And the termination condition, we have considered that the iterations will be performed till the final temperature is less than 1. So in this way, the using these parameters, the algorithm will iterate, and this algorithm we have implemented using a program developed in the MATLAB 2017 programming environment. So this is a kind, these are the kind of results based on a kind of implementation with these operational and the parameters of the simulated handling algorithm. So the maintenance decision will be in terms of a repair action for the component, the replacement action for the component, and for the few component, the decision will be based on the in terms of the do nothing. So the table shows the results which are obtained based on the implementation of the simulated handling algorithm, and the figure besides the table, it indicates the fluctuations or the iterations, the total cost progress over the iterations of the simulated handling algorithm. So you can see that during initial stages, it shows a large variation in terms of searching for the solution throughout the solution space. But as the temperature it reduces, it shows the decision gets stabilized, and at certain temperature level, then the results are stable in terms of obtaining the near optimal decision. So in conclusion, in this paper, we have considered a selective maintenance decision model to determine the individual maintenance action for the component in terms of the repair, replace, or do nothing for a multi-component system. And the total cost of the maintenance decision in this paper we have considered is as an objective function or the fitness function for the a simulated handling algorithm is used for optimization of the decision parameters. And of course, this approach is useful to maintenance manager to decide the maintenance action for the individual component, because during the planned maintenance opportunity, it gets a very critical decision for the maintenance manager that what kind of maintenance treatment that needs to be given for an individual component. So this approach will result in the maintenance action for the individual component, and of course it will be in the requirement with the availability or the other requirement in terms of the maintenance resources that are available. So of course, based on the maintenance actions, the maintenance manager will be able to plan for the resources effectively. Definitely, this approach will help the maintenance manager to effectively plan for the resources as well. As a future scope, we are looking for considering this model as a multi-objective problem, because in this paper we have considered the availability requirement as the one of the requirement for the maintenance manager. But then of course reliability is also one of the important parameter for the manufacturing equipment, or is one of the critical decision. So we are looking forward for formulating this problem and model as a multi-objective problem. And of course, we need to fine-tune the simulated handling algorithm with the different parameter settings for the optimization decisions. And also, we are looking forward for comparing how the performance gets compared with the other solution methodologies like particle swarm optimization or a genetic algorithm. And also we are looking forward for how we can develop or how we can combine it, the selective maintenance decision with the other shop floor functions like the production, maybe the inventory, quality control. And of course, we are looking for developing the complexity in terms of the integrated models based on the selective maintenance decision for multi-machine system, and the research is going on in this direction. So these are the references for this research that this is undergoing, and I thank you for your time. If there are any questions, I am ready to answer and I'm open to answer those questions. Thank you.
Thank you.